We are now here for the final of the Unilever Startup Battle. So first, can we have a big round of applause for our judges sitting at the front? We have Rahul from Unilever, we have Mark Worth from Stylus, and we have Lily from NUS and also the co-chair of this event. So let's get on. We're gonna have the first company coming in. We have NeoReach. You have 4 minutes on the clock, followed by 1 minute of questions. Let's give them a big round of applause. Come on, round of applause. There we go.
All right.
Your time starts now. Good luck.
Is there a clicker? Where's your clicker? I don't know.
Has he got his clicker? Sorry.
Sure, thank you.
Good time. Yes? Awesome. Yes? Yes? Can we have a cheer?
Yeah.
Good. Right, here we go. Your 4 minutes.
All right. So, my name is Jesse. I am the CEO of NeoReach, and we are an influencer marketing platform. If you're not familiar with influencer marketing, you may be familiar with famous YouTubers and famous bloggers, social media stars. Well, these guys have a huge, huge audience, and that audience is extremely valuable to brands. But if you have done influencer marketing, you know how challenging it is to find the right influencers, to make sure these influencers are the right fit, to negotiate with these influencers. And if you're at a large organization, communicating across your organization is even more challenging. Well, NeoReach has a three-part solution. We have made it easy for brands to search for the right influencers. Make sure they are the perfect fit for your brand. You can search influencers by brand affinity, demographics, age breakdown, income breakdown. You can manage the relationship with those influencers. That means communicate with them, issue payments, track campaigns, and then the tracking and analytics. This is the most critical piece. For brands, understanding the value of impressions is difficult. But we make it easy to see exactly what your ROI was from an influencer. How many engagements did you get? How many views? We are currently powering the influencer marketing campaigns at a number of large brands: Walmart, Microsoft, NBC, Amazon, New York Times. These guys use NeoReach software to find influencers, manage the campaigns, and track their results. First part, searching influencers. As you can see, you can input a query, who you're trying to target, what is their age demographics, their gender breakdown, and the system will put the exact influencers that are perfect for you right at the top of the screen. Then you can get detailed analytics reports, exactly who they are, if they're good for you, how much should you pay them, how do you get in touch with them. These reports are critical to marketers to make sure that they are pitching the right, or they're hitting the right audience. But as I said, the management of these campaigns is a mess. At a large organization, you've got agencies, PR teams, in-house teams, brand teams, and it is so hard to get them all on the same page. Managing hundreds of influencers does not make this process any easier, but on NeoReach, it is a piece of cake. On one platform, you can seamlessly see all of the influencers across your organization. You can track who's working with each influencer, how much they've paid them. And this network is valuable to brands. These influencers, they become brand advocates. If they did a good job promoting one product, you probably want to use them to promote another product. Well, on NeoReach, you can centralize that network and give yourselves a proprietary advantage over your competitors. And as I said, the last part, the tracking. The analytics is so critical to these campaigns. You need to understand which influencer performed the best. Did the audience like it? Did the content resonate with the audience? Well, our tracking and analytics dashboard does exactly that. I studied data and analytics and computer science at Stanford, as did our lead engineers, and we've brought that technology and those insights right to your dashboard. So there are a lot of competitors out there. There's a ton of marketplaces, a ton of agencies. Influencer marketing is a space that is rapidly expanding, but we are the only one on the market that searches 3 million influencers, the entire graph. We are an end-to-end solution. You do not need to use any other technology to run these campaigns. You can truly bring it into one place. We have deep, deep analytics and insights. You will not get data like this anywhere else. And the ability to build your own database gives you a competitive advantage over everybody else. So I'll leave you with this quote. Marketing platforms, Nearreach is by far the greatest, by NBC. Thank you.
Thank you. So let's hear from the judges. Let's start with Rahul. Stay.
So that's thank you very much. A very energetic presentation. What's in it for the influencers? Why would they want to work with you?
Yeah, so the influencers, they get paid for their endorsements from the brand. They also often get exclusive access. They get to work with brands they like. But we are not making this market. Over $2 billion was paid out to influencers last year. We're just providing the software to facilitate it.
What stage of the business? Have you launched? Do you have revenues? What is your revenue model?
Six figures a month recurring. It's a subscription license paid on an annual basis. Customers like Walmart, Amazon, Microsoft, they're already using the technology.
Yeah. No question. My question is almost the same. How are you making money from it? So six figures per month?
Yes. Yeah, we've already done over seven figures in revenue last year, and it's growing pretty nicely. So it's an annual subscription license, so brands will pay.
So what's the retaining rate on a year-by-year of your subscription?
We're only 2 years in, so we have not had many cancellations. But the lock-in for the brand is pretty good because it really helps them manage all of their external relations, manage the payments, the contracts. So once they start using it, it facilitates so much that they don't really want to leave it.
Sorry, how much are they paying a year?
Well, it depends on the brand, but licenses range from $2,000 a month up to $25,000 a month.
Great. Thank you very much. Well done. Let's give them a big round of applause. Okay, up next, let's keep the applause for Winamy.
Hi, good evening. I'm Swami Shekhar. This is RK Hiramani, and we are the co-founders of Winamy. Our platform, CChat, is live on iOS and Android today. We are focused on addressing the global pain point that exists in customer-to-business communication. And we know that's broken because there is a synchronous communication model today, which results in experiences like this.
Other callers at this time. Please remain on the line, and the next available agent will be with you momentarily.
And this is not just with large enterprises like telcos and banks where you're staying on the phone, but also with SMEs, which today still rely on office hours, receptionists, and landlines for customers to connect with them. And that's a broken model because when we look at studies shown by Gartner, over 89% of the businesses today think customer service and customer experience is how they want to differentiate themselves against other brands. Yet, that's not possible today because the existing CRM models and messaging platforms are broken in addressing their needs. Why is it broken? Because an SME's need is simple. It has to be low cost, ready to use, and meet their unique day-to-day operating model, which involves delegation, shifts, change of workers, etc. But if you look at an enterprise, the needs become different. They usually have a big brand with outlets and customers, and they want a holistic communication strategy that covers their distribution chain, and they are able to get full transparency on how a customer is engaging with an outlet, though they are back in the brand, back in the office. And ideally, they would like the data of the communication to roll back to their CRM. Lastly, as a customer, you see an app fatigue because there are too many businesses coming out with apps these days.
So CChat, we offer as the solution. It's a truly a many-to-many solution. It's a gateway for connecting many businesses to many consumers. At the heart of CChat is essentially this business directory, which has a listing of businesses which consumers can choose and have instant communication with the businesses with rich media experiences, such as photos and videos. Now, Ben is actually a physio in Singapore, and he has chosen to be on CChat. By being on CChat, he gets a global visibility, as well as consumers are able to reach Ben through his business name, not through a mobile number. That helps build him brand equity. Not only that, he's able to differentiate his service and also elevate the customer experience by giving his customers an ability to connect anytime, from anywhere, through instant messaging service that people love today, right? And he's able to do the same thing without revealing his mobile number, and also the cost of engagement goes down by 50 to 90% with the CChat platform. SMEs like Ben can include multiple business members like receptionists or others into the platform as they grow their businesses, And the business members can choose to respond to the customer queries depending on what the question is. You can also change the business members depending on staffing and shift changes and so forth. Those are available through this platform. Now, when you go to the second challenge that is related to the brand outlets, if you connect all the outlets on a CChat platform, the consumers are able to reach the brand outlets through CChat. Not only that, we are able to take the solution and connect it back into the centralized CRM, which can be an enterprise CRM such as Salesforce or others. Here's actually a solution that we have implemented that shows CChat prototype working with a Salesforce Service Cloud, the largest SaaS provider in terms of CRM. In this case, a mobile user is actually using a rich platform, a rich media like photo to communicate with the customer service. So what have we done? We're offering one platform that scales all the way from small business to large enterprises as part of a solution that integrates messaging. Our vision is to actually monetize $36 billion in opportunity by connecting billions of users to 100 million businesses and connecting also extending into IoT.
Okay, that's
Thank
it.
You.
Thank you. Right. Let's hear from Lily.
How do you make money from this? What's your revenue model for this?
Sure. I think we missed it here. If we can get the slides, please.
No, just answer that.
Okay, so we have three SKUs. One is entry. When the business enrolls themselves, they get one business number for free. As they scale the business members onto the platform, we charge them $3 per month per user to include more business members into it. We also have a pre-CRM solution that costs about $15 per month per user to be added onto the platform. We do enterprise SKUs that depends on the enterprise customization and stuff, which can range anywhere from 100K to 200K per deal, and a subscription of about $50,000. That's our model.
And how long has the business been going?
2 weeks. We are in public beta right now, and we are going to launch our product fully on June 6th when our revenue products are available.
Very good, thank you. Great presentation, enjoyed it, and I think I like I can relate to the problem that you described in that short video.
Fantastic. We have validated it with many businesses, and they've told us the same thing.
Good.
Thank you very much.
Thank you.
Great. Thank you very much. Right. The stage is you, my friend. Big round of applause. Your 4 minutes begins now.
Hi, everyone. I'm Matthew, CEO and Next User. So basically, we orchestrate data and marketing tool together. So think about us like a marketing middleware. We connect to all the applications, and we act like a maestro driving an orchestra. The goal is to have all the channels and all the devices brought together to create what user experience like Amazon style. So we give each brand and each e-commerce website the same capability. So what we are solving for is organizational silo. Tools are in silo. And we basically create a seamless user journey across all the user touch points. We can incorporate any type of interaction. So we are connecting to each of the API, whether it's email service provider, SMS, mobile, web, etc. And we aggregate all user data coming from online data, social media data, wearables, personality with IBM Watson, a community, and many more. Let me show you our platform in action. So we have the capability to profile anonymous users. So we create a user, and we see everything from activity, visit, history, location, device. The goal is to personalize the user experience, like we do here, based on location. It can be based also on the previous content that they viewed. It can be based as well on the marketing channel, and also based on the type of product or their browser behavior. We can retarget them in multi-channel, so email, personalization, mobile, SMS, customer support. As well, as we have some capability around artificial intelligence. So we have three products. We were selected by IBM Watson 1 year ago. First product we have is Personality Insight. So we have, based on social media, the capability to show any type of user profile. Here we will see Bill Gates. We can also analyze the voice of the customer, so all the emotion according to reviews or any comments, so we can tell you exactly what's happening. And we have also the capability to do a conversation, whether through text or vocal. So we work with a few big companies. We are an IBM Watson partner, Google partner, and we are also a Dell Founder Club as well. Total addressable market is 12 billion. We are between marketing automation and discovery analytics. Our key differentiator is that we integrate to existing channel. So it's very easy to say to a brand, let's give us a try. We basically personalize for a brand. We do an A/B test. We show them a few benefits of personalization. And generally, we get 3 to 4 brands after a pilot. So it can be engagement like Nestle. It could be a pure e-commerce like Alibris in the US or Yellow Corner between retail and online in Europe. Basically, we were created in March 2013. We launched commercially in October 2014. We have a partnership with IBM, Dell Founder Club, Google. So we have 17 members, team members. We raised around 2 million at a seed stage. And our primary focus is brand, digital, and e-commerce. And we work also with marketing agencies. Thank you very much, guys. Any questions? Mark?
Is this patented technology? Have you applied for patents?
Sorry?
Patents. Have you applied for patents on this technology?
Yes. It was presented shortly. I covered it. It's on the left. So the goal is to personalize the content, whether the condition is met or is not met. So we have a retargeting logic, integrating all the APIs, so all the marketing channel. And we have the capability to show. I cannot, could not show you, it was a bit complex. But yes, we applied for a patent back in March 2014 in the US.
Great.
Lily?
Nice work.
Thank you very much.
You mentioned 97% of the users are anonymous, but the reality is that with Facebook, Twitter, Google, and you know, just about everybody is identifiable in some way. So how does this provide a competitive edge to the campaigns?
It provides integration with campaigns based on referrer, any regular expression, time of the day, geolocation, device, any information we capture. 97% is because for consumer website, generally, not everyone is creating an account, signing up to the newsletter, making a purchase, or going into a community where they identify. So basically, this statistics is not coming from me, it's coming from Google, and it's based on the consumer website. So what we want to do is a continuity according to whatever traffic. So it could be a referrer like Facebook, it could be paid search, it could be a newsletter that you will indicate with, for Google Analytics, it will be UTM parameter or any regular expression like Adobe system, etc. And what we do is we integrate also with marketing tools. So we have an integration with Optimizely as well, A/B testing in Europe, Adobe test on target, etc. What we want to show the brand is a lift in terms of incremental driven by the personalization. And we generally do a Google Analytics study of 50 pages to exactly tell them, according to the current data, some segment of user where we can personalize at a one-on-one level.
Thank you. Any more questions? Great, thank you. Big round of applause. Up next, we have Live Room. Keep them applaud. Hello. Thank you. Here you go, guys.
Hi, good evening. I'm Samir, the founder and CTO of Live Room. So, have you ever wasted money on something that you still regret by? Well, that ends here at Live Room, because we bring products virtually to your own space, and we make sure that you will never make another bad purchase. So, the problem. Currently, customers does not have trustworthy solutions to try before buying. Because of this reason, online retail stores and e-commerce sites, they have a pretty low sales conversion rates and a pretty high product return rate. So the solution. The solution is a cloud-based virtual showroom platform powered by the latest augmented reality technology, which can be easily integrated with any e-commerce site or any existing e-commerce site. So, this is how an e-commerce site would look when integrated with Live Room. So within one button click or within one QR code scan, you can actually try the product. Now, as you can see in that video demonstration, he's actually trying out the that particular product, the chair, with the help of an iPad. So that's our platform. And you can try out anything from furniture to jewelry to any kind of product. And we make sure that you see our all the products in real size, realistic lighting conditions. And we use realistic graphic rendering techniques to make sure that you will get an actual feeling of the product. So we have a pretty straightforward business model. We charge based on the number of products you put on our platform. And we expect average monthly subscription to be $1,000. And for our premium customers, we provide business analytics and backend integration so they can cater their customers well. So currently we are targeting online retail stores and omnichannel retailers, those who have online presence as well as the physical presence. And we have calculated now we have an $1.5 billion total accessible market, and we are planning to capture 10% of that market within first 5 years of operation. So LiveRoom has a steady and stable plan to become the preferred shopping assistant of all the e-commerce sites and for all the people. And we are planning to make LiveRoom a globally recognized brand by 2022. And you might know that the augmented reality headsets and augmented reality wearable devices are coming in soon near future. So we will be developing this LiveRoom platform for the Microsoft HoloLens and similar products as well. So since augmented reality is a brand new technology, we have very low number of global competitors. And so except LiveRoom, all of the other, four of the other companies are US based and one is Finnish company. So we are the first in Asia to do this. And so main competitive advantage we have is the easy e-commerce integration. We can integrate LiveRoom with any e-commerce platform very quickly and easily without doing much work. And we have the iOS support and Android support. And actually we have the wearable device support currently. And we provide comprehensive business analytics as well as the LiveRoom is highly scalable than other products because we can set up a LiveRoom faster than other products. So when we started LiveRoom 8 months ago, now we have, thank you.
Very good, thank you.
Do you have any questions?
No question. I think exciting idea. I'm sure e-commerce sites will benefit from it.
Who is your client? Is your client the, is it a B2B or is it a B2C?
This is B2B. We are charging from the businesses.
Yeah, and do you have any take up already? Have you launched it?
Yeah, we have launched it back in Sri Lanka with one of our local customers. Actually, we are planning to come to the international market by the end of this year.
So do you have any retailers using it yet? Okay. How many?
Excuse me?
How many retailers are using this?
We have only one customer up to now, so we are planning to expand.
Would you be able to do it for clothing? Would you be able to do it for clothing? Clothing.
Actually, clothing is pretty much difficult, but it's in our process of doing it. So for our next release, we are developing LiveRoom for the fashion accessories like glasses, the wristwatches, and clothing is next. Any other questions?
Thank you very much. Right, we're down to our final three. So now let's hear it for Nia.
So, thank you for the opportunity. I'd like to draw your attention to Minority Report now for a second. So think Tom Cruise walking through the MRT, getting Mr. Anderton your Guinness, Mr. Anderton your Lexus. So think very similar to that. That's what NIA is. We're the largest location audience curation platform in the world. We're actually headquartered in Singapore and across the world. So I'll quickly walk you through what we did. So very simply, about 7 years ago, we drove the whole world and picked up Wi-Fi and telco signals. That led to us actually mapping the whole world. With that, we literally know all the location coordinates in the world. And with that, we started building people's profiles, literally like a Hansel and Gretel trail. Please note, this is all PII compliant. We don't know who you are, we just know your device ID. So literally, it looks like this. You're at home, the ID goes to a gym, the ID goes to an office, the ID goes to shopping, downloads apps. And so what we basically know is that you're a female affluent professional because of the profiling and the various other data sets that we have in our set. So we have currently over 710 million users profiled. We work for 300 over of the marquee brands. We've also been collecting data for over 7 years, and we've actually, right now, the use cases are targeted marketing and, of course, attribution measurement, but there's so much more we can do with this, which is why we're launching our platform, which is called AllSpark, and I'll show that to you very soon. These are NERS data sets, which are many, so we've collected billions of location footprints across the world. App data is where we get our current refresh in terms of data sets. We also work with the largest navigation people in the world, like Here Maps, which is my former job, and Google, et cetera. This all works into and very seamlessly moves into a system called AllSpark, which simply pulls out two people and places APIs, which I'll show you very soon. Please play video. That's our live location and audience curation tool, literally from the ability for you to curate an audience. So a brand can actually seamlessly start to curate an audience that they want to target. Target them where they want to target them, so pick a place. So the natural language search machinery lets you just pick keywords and it picks out the brands you want to target. And at the locations you want to target them. And on the right-hand side, you'll start to see the estimated reach on top and the analytics you can do in terms of setting radiuses, etc. So if you want to target a competition, you pick a further radius. You can start to build that audience card, save it to your account, and start to create a campaign right off the bat. So this is one of the simplest tools in the world ever created, and I worry when I sell it because I think it's too simple. And you can actually, if you don't want to pick individual places, you can actually go and build a polygon. And this is right now showing you where you can target your competition and build different line items for each. So each campaign can have multiple line items. And the most interesting thing is we have live reporting. So everything on AllSpark is real-time live. And that's the critical thing about this platform. So you don't have to wait to hit the iceberg before your ship sinks on a campaign. You know what's going on in the campaign right off the bat. So that is AllSpark. We don't have time for a live demo, but I'm happy to see all of you guys outside to show you a live demo. Thank you.
Wow, that was perfect timing. Right, let's hear from Lily.
How long did it take you to curate all that information?
So from the data that we collected to the platform,
yes.
So the platform took us about 6 months to build because the data has been collecting over the last 7 years.
And have you launched already? Do you have clients?
AllSpark is live already. So AllSpark is basically the front end now of the data that already existed. So we've been live for about 3 years running campaigns for various brands. It's just now the flappy feet up front. So that we are the first in the world and probably the only who will be completely transparent with data. So the data is completely transparent on every campaign. We don't edit anything.
Very good, thank you.
Sorry, the model is what, an annual subscription?
Yeah, so now AllSpark is a SaaS model, so yes, there is an annual subscription fee, platform usage fee.
And have you got clients that have renewed already, or?
So AllSpark as a tool launched in Feb, so yes, there are people already on the tool, so they have a minimum commitment of revenue on the tool, and they're already spending.
Okay.
Thank you.
Rahul?
Thank you.
Great, thank you very much. Okay. Here we go, let's make some noise for Precision Bait.
All right, wanna make sure this mic works. Hi, everyone. My name's Rhea, and I'm CEO of PrecisionVit. We're a seed stage company. We're based in Singapore, and we're happy to say that we're part of the first cohort of Telstra's acceleration program, the very first one in the region. So in case you didn't notice, something significant has happened in the past couple years. There's now 1.8 billion images that are uploaded online every day. And for consumers in the room, we all take pictures, and these really reflect what all of us are passionate about. But for the marketers, I'm not sure if there's anyone here who's a marketer, for the marketers in here, most of the tools that we use can actually only currently read text really well about consumer insight. In fact, if you see this over here on the right, this person's talking about a tiger that's running somewhere. And on the right, this person's talking about ice cream on a Friday. But what you don't see is the amount of customer insight that's actually present in a photo. This person's not talking about tiger as in the animal, but tiger beer. And this person's out there in the summer and outdoors. And over here, it's not just ice cream, but this person is with his family, with his kids, somewhere in a park. There's a lot of insight about shoppers and customers that brands right now are currently still blind to. We make that visible. At PrecisionVit, we help companies get insight from social photos, which they use for improved audience profiling and messaging. How it works? First, you're able to query a keyword, a social ID, or a particular location. We then take that image data set, we're able to look into each and every single photo, identify objects, emotions, scenes, and we're able to identify different objects from scenarios. We then take that data, look at the different patterns and trends, and help you understand different kinds of audience profiles. How is this used? The most common use case that we have is actually for customer profiling. So in this case, for this lady, based on the photos that she posts, we're able to identify, is she more likely to be an outdoor enthusiast or a yoga buff? But let me bring this to life for you. One of our clients is an insurance company in the Philippines, and they wanted to target a new audience segment, which was travelers. So what did they do? Using PrecisionVit, they queried a particular location. This is an expressway where a lot of these travelers pass through over the weekend. And given the timeline of about a week, we were able to get 1,000 photos. But what's interesting is we were able to see that of all that image data, the key theme was actually these people are family vacationers. But more importantly, these are people in the car with their family, with a kid. So that company took that intelligence, completely overhauled their visual message, which before using PrecisionVit was something around a medical theme, and they changed it to this. And the result was they got 2 times the number of signups for the same budget. And as I mentioned, we are right now at our beta phase, and we just launched a month ago. But within that span of time, we were able to secure paid pilots from some of the biggest companies in the region. But why is this important? Because last year, $1.6 billion was spent by companies globally on text-based solutions to help them understand social data about customers. This is poised to grow to become a $5 billion market in just a few years. The great thing about PrecisionVit is that these current players currently still cannot do image analytics. So they're a great go-to-market channel for us, and that's our opportunity. And across our team and advisors, we've built and sold marketing technology solutions across Fortune 500 companies worldwide. For myself, previously a consumer product goods marketer, before crossing over to the dark side of the commerce.
Thank you.
Thank you.
Rahul.
Very good. So you see this as a subscription model which will be used by the agencies or the marketers?
Good question. Depends on the company. If they have a large agency handling their campaigns, then it's definitely the agency. It's a SaaS model. So, but some companies, we go direct. If they have their own in-house thing, if they want to do it in-house.
When do you think you'll be ready to go to market and actually sell?
We're actually selling right now. So we're getting revenue. We launched our automated solution just a month ago since we were part of the program. But within that span of time, we were already able to get paid pilots.
No additional questions.
Thank you very much. Okay, and our last company, Ad and Platform. Here we go, the stage is yours.
Hello, everybody. I'm Wen Ting. I'm the CEO of K-Wisdom. Thank you so much for staying late for us. Well, Key Wisdom does 24/7 AI-driven marketing optimization and automation. Anybody, marketers here, probably can relate to this problem, right? Let's look at marketers' daily struggles. First of all, there are underperforming campaigns allowed to run that cost you wasted impressions and opportunities. There are too many parameters out there, too many platforms. Missing some of them could cause you to lose opportunities to convert. Then there are too much data out there across different platforms. Just compile and compare them takes you hours or days. How do we help? Well, take myself, if I'm a marketer, I have to look at all these markets, then I have to launch all these campaigns with different content, focus, target groups, then I have to figure out where am I going to launch them to. How are we going to help then? We help you to boost the ad relevance 24/7 with our AI engine. How do we do that? Look at all these green dots. These are all the possible combinations you could have to launch your marketing campaigns. But A, if you are to test all of them by yourself manually, it could take you months. But if we're using the AI engine right now, just a few hours, a few days. We also take care of all your historical campaign performance. We run systematic testing on the sampling so that we verify the assumptions and insights are correct. With a few iterations, we help you to bring the cost down, the performance up. Your prediction is only as good as how fast you can react to your data. That's what we offer to the marketers, 10 times more effective and 10 times more faster. The market we're looking at is this fast-growing marketing automation market that has grown from just a couple of $100 million to $1.6 billion over the last 5 years. But we're not looking at enterprise solutions. We're targeting the small and medium businesses who cannot afford to look for the big marketing agencies. This market is worth about $800 million, and it's growing at about 48% annual growth rate. This is how our product looks like. It's a SaaS system, campaign-specific, cross-channel. You can access it anywhere, anytime, easy to use. Let me recap our advantages that we can offer to the marketers. API integration, we can connect to almost any digital marketing channel through API, Google, Facebook, email, you name it. Fast, we're 10 times faster. Accurate, we can help you to improve your marketing performance by 30%. Easy to use. We put everything on the one platform. You can monitor, manage everything at one place. We have been working with a lot of interesting clients, some of the biggest ones, Decathlon, the biggest sportswear retailer in the world, and we have been working with agencies as well. We have very strong partnership, including SPH. My awesome team consists of the top-tier scientists and business leaders in the region, very good developers and product guys. That's all. Thank you.
Thank you. Mark.
This is what, a subscription model?
Subscription, SaaS model.
With agencies, presumably.
Well, we work with brands and agencies, but the model will be slightly different.
Okay. How long did it take you to develop the AI?
2 years?
Yeah. And it was done at the university?
Yes.
So you licensed?
We got a Sprint TCS, so we developed the technology, and then we pivoted, and then we got some support, and then continued to build and pivoted, and then, yeah, 2 years.
So it's licensed from the university, or does it belong to you?
This is actually proprietary IP that we developed under the company, but we work with other universities at the same time.
Okay, thank you.
Yeah, thank you.
Thank you so much.
Thank you very much. Okay, that is all the companies. So what's going to happen now is Rahul, Mark, and Lily are going to have a quick chat. They're going to decide the winner. I'd like to invite all the companies to come on stage in a line, and then we will announce the winner. I'll just check. just waiting one more minute. Are you all right there? Very good. So we'll see, they're just having a clear, hard debate who it's going to be. Well, you've all done very well. You've all had some amazing pitches. Just to let you know, there was over 100 companies applied, filtered down. There was a semi-final yesterday, which you all got to get to see. So I think before we begin, we should give them all a round of applause. I think there. Any chance we're getting near? Oh, is there? So, how many of you are from Singapore again? Based in Singapore? Where are you based? Can I have a handheld, please? Thank you. So, you're based in Sri Lanka?
Yeah.
So, firstly, we've got an amazing Sri Lankan delegation here. So, congratulations going through. Okay, Sri Lanka's a growing ecosystem, and they're great to be part of InnovFest unBound. You live here as well?
San Francisco.
San Francisco. Gosh, you came all the way from San Francisco to meet Unilever. So fantastic. How did you like living in the Valley?
It was very good. Very good contact for us. Very interesting. Really like it.
And you're a Frenchman, so this is a
real... I am a Frenchman.
This is a real international event. A Frenchman living in San Francisco here in Singapore.
Yeah, exactly.
I bet you have very good air miles.
Yes.
Who's your favorite airline?
Air France.
Air France, typical. French. Mark Goldberg, you in the audience as well. I think he's not there. What about you? Where are you from?
Was based in Singapore, now recently relocated to Oregon, Portland, Oregon.
Oh, another American. Gosh, yeah. You're coming in. And you like Air France as well?
No, actually, Singapore Air.
Singapore Airline. Oh, very good. SQ. And what about yourself?
Live in Singapore. But I have a question. How good is the customer service for SQ and France?
All right, we're not an airline contest, but let's go there. What about yourself? Where are you from?
San Francisco.
San Francisco. Gosh, so we got Americans and Singaporeans. Right, I'm going to find out the winner. Can you turn my mic off so no one hears? Gentlemen, we have a winner. I'd like to invite Rahul, who is, this is the Unilever battle, onto the stage. So are we all ready to find out who it's gonna be? Are we ready?
Do I need this?
Okay, great. Listen, this is a great privilege to be recognizing all the startups, fantastic presentations from all of them. Really difficult to choose the winner. And as you saw, you know, there was some sort of a debate between all of us, and we couldn't really come to a conclusion early on, but as is often the case, we did reach a consensus, so great. On behalf of Unilever, I'd like to thank all the startups for participating in this. I know that these are seven proud shortlisted finalists from 100 over contestants, so great job. And unfortunately or fortunately, we have the privilege of choosing one winner. And the winner for us is Next User. So Next User is the proud winner of the Unilever Startup Battle. Congratulations.
Thank you. Yeah?
Congratulations.
Good job. Thank you very much. Let's get a picture with these two and then get a picture with all the finalists. Camera.
Come
on. Lily and Mark, come on stage, have a picture with all the finalists. So ladies and gentlemen, while this is happening, this is it. InnovFest Unbound 2016 is over. A big thank you to you all for coming. A big thank you to all our partners, all our sponsors, all of you. There was over 6,300 of you coming, making this Southeast Asia's largest event. Let's get the picture with you guys, snap away. I'd like to also, on behalf of NUS Enterprise, Unbound, IDA, thank you all for coming. Can I invite also everybody from NUS Enterprise onto the stage, IDA if you're here. Team Unbound onto the stage. Let's all come on for a picture. And Barbara from Unilever, thank you to Barbara from the Foundry. This is her baby, who's great partnering with you for the second year running. So come on the stage, thank you. NUS, come on Irene, I see you over there. Sean, Kelvin, Dawn, MJ, Brenda, Gabe. Where are you, Ruin? Michael, Anthony, Sophie, Kelvin, come on, Brenda. Brenda, come on stage, I'll just keep speaking. Dawn, where are you, Dawn? Come on, Dawn. Everyone give Dawn a big round of applause. She had to put up with me for too long. So come on, let's get a group picture, everybody. Thank you. Thank you, Anthony.